What's up, everyone? Today you guys are going to identify the different cables required to boot up a Raspberry Pi and the three parts of an electric circuit. And you guys will demonstrate this knowledge by building a simple circuit to light up an LED light, and that's going to look like this. So the first thing is, what is a Raspberry Pi? It's a single board computer. It can do lots of stuff like the computers that you're normally used to, but the benefit are these GPIO, general purpose input output pins over here, that will let us connect to physical components like these little LED lights. And the ultimate goal of learning what's called physical computing is to be able to experience how do we as humans make computers do stuff. Now, to make this project where we have a traffic light sequence, we'll need to know a little bit more and program it to happen. But today you don't need any programming. We are simply going to make a circuit, and that way this is the goal that we're building up to. So in this physical computing unit, what you will do is you will learn how computer hardware works. This is the physical components of a machine. You will grow your problem-solving abilities by troubleshooting and figuring out what's not happening, which will require you to be creative, and it's very hands-on. So where we're going to start is by making a circuit. Well, what is a circuit? A circuit is simply a device that can move electricity through itself to power other devices. And every circuit needs three things. It needs power, it needs a conductor, and it needs to be closed. Power is simply a source of electricity. So our Raspberry Pi over here, power is simply coming from this USB-C cable over here. Power is now inside the Raspberry Pi, and we are going to then use a conductor over here. So a conductor is a material that allows electric currents to pass through them. So power is coming from this USB-C cable to the Raspberry Pi. And then we have difference of 40 GPIO pins. The top left GPIO pin is 3 volts of power, 3.3 volts of power. The one on the third row and the three down is the ground over here. So if we take a look at this little diagram, the power, which is now in the Raspberry Pi, which we need in a circuit, and then we're going to use these wires as conductors to allow that electricity to flow through them. So it's going to come through this USB-C port to the Raspberry Pi. The top left is 3.3 volts of power. And this cord over here is flowing over to this thing, which is called a breadboard, which is just a prototype for making a circuit. The word breadboard is a little silly, but it allows us to prototype circuits and keep us organized. You can see these parts won't fall out. So power is coming from our USB-C port through the Raspberry Pi up through 3.3 volts of power over to the breadboard. Now all of these channels over here in a row, so everything in a single row, these are all connected. So power is going to flow from this over to this little thing, which is called a resistor, which we'll go over later. Then it's going to flow down through the resistor and then up through the LED light, down through the LED light, and back to the ground over here, which is essentially what we're going to go over later, but that's essentially what's happening. So we need a source of power, which we have through the Raspberry Pi. We need conductors, which we have in these cables over here. And the third thing we need in the circuit is simply for the circuit to be closed. You'll notice that this little light is off because this cable is not plugged in, which is the ground cable. Only the power cable is plugged in. And even though the power is plugged in, the light's not going to light up until we plug this into the ground. So the three parts that we need for every circuit is power, a conductor, and for the circuit to be closed. That way electricity can fully make the loop and then continue going over here. So to build this, we are going to need a couple of parts. We are going to need a Raspberry Pi, which you guys have. You guys will need a breadboard, which is this prototype for circuits. You'll need a resistor, which will make it so that this little LED light bulb will not explode because we don't want too much electricity flowing through it. The resistor will resist the electricity. It will lower the electricity. And you will need three conductor wires over here. Two of them are going to be male-female. Then you guys, I mentioned the word hardware. Hardware is a physical component. Software is a programmer code that runs on top of these physical components. So you will notice that we're using these things called LEDs, and LEDs are one directional, which means that if you plug in the long side over here into the ground, it will not turn on. The long leg over here must get plugged into the power. And you'll also notice that this resistor is happening before it gets to the light bulb, the LED, because it lowers the electricity, and then it flows one way back to the ground. You guys will try reversing it, and you'll just notice that the light bulb will not light up because an LED is a one-directional device. It has to be plugged into this order in order for it to work. Finally, this circuit is able to, as I mentioned, turn on without programming, without software. Simply plugging it in will allow us to light up this little LED light. So that's what we're going to go do. I hope you guys enjoy. I'll see you guys in the next video, and let's go do it. Peace.